Alright, put your hands behind your legs. And then curl your tailbone under. Lower yourself down to your low back. And then curl yourself back up. And sit up tall. And repeat that motion. One more. Breathing out. Breathing in. Same thing with your arms in the front. Try to roll your low back down first. And then curl yourself back up. One more time like that, part way down. And now come all the way down. Bring your arms above your head, stretch your legs and your arms. Like someone's pulling you from your wrists and ankles. And bend your legs, hands behind your head, and curl up. One more. Hold this next one up and alternate marching your legs. Try to keep your shoulder blades off the ground. 4, 3, 2, 1. Straighten out your right leg and lower and lift. 2 more. Other side. 2 more. Reach with that leg. And come on down. Rock your tailbone back and forth. So tailbone to ceiling, pressing your low back to the ground. And release. And repeat. Tailbone to ceiling, press your low back to the ground. You're light on your feet. You're not squeezing your glutes. You're initiating from your center. And release. 4 more. 4, 3, 2. And hold this next one here with your low back pressed to the ground, arms by your side. Hold your legs one at a time. This is different from what we were doing before. What we were doing before, our shoulders were up, our low back was not on the ground, and this time our low back is pressing on the ground as we're floating our legs up. Keep that press of your lumbar spine to the mat, and your sacrum and tailbone curled up. 2 more. All right, straighten your right leg out and lower lift. Trying to keep your low back on the ground. Switch sides. Of your midfoot. Before it's too late, Your right glute. Okay, put that left leg down, your right leg is crossed over, press your hands to the ground, and press into your left heel to lift and lower. So we're not curling up and down, we're just lifting now, straight back. Up, down, up, down, up, a little bit, like 1 inch. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Down, up, down, up. Switch sides. And up. Up and down. big cloud coming that way, but right over me, no big cloud. Or a bird just peed on me, possibly. I hope not. Four, three, two, one. Switch sides. Alright, legs are bent, bottom arm bent. And open it up, take a look, glance over to that side. Behind you. And come on back, straighten your legs, except for the top one, and open and close top leg. Top arm is up in the air, legs open close. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And now bring that leg in front and lift the bottom leg up and down. And 8 more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, straighten your legs out. Bend onto your stomach. Bend your right leg and get a stretch at the front of your right thigh. And switch sides. Tailbone's tucked under, and your thighs are right next to each other, so you can get a stretch at the front of that right thigh. Alright, bring your arms by your side, head hovering right over the ground. Let your shoulders come straight sideways, like smile your collarbones wide. Put the back of your neck long, so that you're looking down at the ground if your eyes were open. But maybe you want to close them so you don't have to focus on the ground that's so close. Okay, so picture your shoulder blades behind you. They're flat against your rib cage in the back. All right, so keep them there like that, and then make little pulses up and down with your arms. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down. And 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Now arms straight to the side. Lift up, down, up, down. Little lifts. If you feel a squish at your low back, see if you can tuck your tail under along with the back of you. Now bring your arms up. Two and one. Hands by your shoulders. Send your shoulder blades down your back. Lift up your chest. Support from the bottom. And come on down. Oh my gosh, someone is cooking some really good food out here. On this next one, you are going to come down to your elbows, and you're going to kick, alternating your legs. Open the front of your chest, and the goal of this kick to use the back of your legs, but also resist how the kicking of your leg makes you want to squish your low back. So get some support from underneath so that when you kick your leg, it doesn't feel like a compression at your low back. If you need to, you can get lower. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, push back to child's pose. Okay, go onto your hands and knees and lift your right bent leg up and down. Lift, lift. Okay, as you're lifting your leg, think of it as like a pump that's kind of like pumping helium into your upper trunk so that you're floating off the ground. Switch sides. Shoulders back, and we are done.